Are you building AI automation workflows in n8n and sometimes feels like that you're duplicating the same logic across different workflows that you are building? What if there could be a way that you do not need to copy paste the same logic again and again in different workflows and you could reuse the same logic across different workflows that you are building? Welcome to my course on AI automation powered by n8n. In today's lesson, we are going to exactly talk about this problem and I'm going to introduce a very powerful concept that is there in n8n called sub workflows, which helps us make our AI automation workflows faster, cleaner, and more scalable. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to modularize complex tasks, improve the maintainability as well as readability of your workflows, and instantly update multiple workflows by a change at a single place. So what exactly is a sub workflow? Well, a sub workflow is a separate workflow that can be called inside from another workflow. This is done with the help of an execute workflow node, which allows us to call another workflow from your own workflow, pass some input data to it, and receive back the output data from it. But why should you use these sub workflows? Well, the most important reason of using sub workflows is to improve the reusability of same kind of logic that you are putting in place across different workflows that you are building. So these workflows allows us to reduce that duplicity or duplicate effort that you are making by putting the same logic again and again by copy pasting across different workflows. The second reason is to improve the maintainability. You can make a direct change at a single place and all the workflows that are using your sub workflow will get updated. Otherwise, you will have to go and open all those workflows that have that duplicated piece of logic and make the update in all of them. Third is the scalability, because it keeps our workflows clean, structured, and modular. Fourth is the readability, because more structured, more clean your workflow is, you will be able to understand them better when you are coming back after maybe 3 months or 6 months while visiting them. And the final one is performance optimization, because by segregating the logic in different sub workflows, you make them efficient and their execution speed becomes faster. Now let's get to the fun part, where I'll be sharing my screen and building these sub workflow in front of you so that you have a complete understanding of where this kind of concept can be applied and how it can be applied. Alright, I'm logged into the cloud instance of my n8n workspace and you can see that I have first workflow new support ticket handling over here. This workflow will be our starter workflow. I'll start building this workflow and then explain the concept of how we can abstract out some of the logic that we will be building over here, which can be used in other workflows that are there. So for example, over here I have three workflows. Workflow 1, 2, and 3. We are going to use the concept of sub workflow, abstract out some logic, and then first we are going to modularize new support ticket handling system and then reusing that sub workflow in workflow 2 as well as workflow 3. This way you would have a complete understanding of what signals to use in order to abstract out some of the logic in different sub workflows. So in this first workflow, a ticket is received as a webhook from the customer, where a customer email ID is mentioned and ticket message is there. Then in the step 1, we are going to fetch the customer record from using the email that was inputted in the webhook. Next step would be to calculate the VIP status of the customer, with if the total orders are greater than 50 or rating is greater than 4.5, then we assign the VIP tag to that particular customer. If the customer is VIP, we route it to a senior agent so that they can resolve their ticket. However, if it is a normal customer, we assign it by region. If the region is EU, we assign it to European support team, else we assign it to US team. Finally, we log the ticket details in a Google Sheet. Now let's start building this workflow. I'll click on the plus sign and add a webhook trigger. So webhook trigger is here. I'll just leave it as is. We are not going to configure it. Rather, we are going to use the concept of pinning data, editing data, and I'm going to have a demo or sample data or mock data that I showed you how to create that in the last lesson of this course. So go and check that out, how to create sample data for your workflows. Here I'm going to use the sample data that I've already created. Let me first drag it down a bit. Now I'll double click to open it. Click on this edit thing. and control A, control B. So I already have some sample data where the email is mentioned of the customer and ticket message is mentioned. So I have 5 records over. Let's save this one. So these are some of the tickets that we are receiving, and I have deliberately used 5 records, although in a webhook you will be receiving 1 ticket at a time, but this will help us ensure some of the logic that we are going to follow. We can follow along in a single iteration of the workflow. So now our webhook is configured. We have to fetch some customer data. Let's add a Google Sheet node over here. So Google Sheet node, and we are going to say get rows. All right, let me show you the mock data that I already have. I have opened up the sheet. So you can see that this sub workflow mock data sheet, I have various sheets over here: user data, orders data, support tickets, marketing campaign. All these sheets we'll be using in this lesson. In the first sheet, we have the user data where I have customer ID, customer name, email, order history, average rating, and region. So this is more like our CRM. You might be storing this customer data in some other place, so you can use that. However, just for demo purposes, I have this Google sheet over here. So we are going to select this one. It was sub workflows mock data, sheet was user data. So, and then we are going to apply some filters over here, add a filter, and we are going to apply the filter on the email that we are getting. So email column is there, and we are getting an email in the webhook as well. So we are going to filter those records. Now, if I go into execute this, it is going to fetch the records of the customer, which is matching the email in the webhook, who are submitting these support tickets. So now, this data we have received, it has a row number, it has customer ID, customer name, email, order history, average rating, and region. So we have automated this step one, fetch customer record from the email. Now what we should do is we should merge these two data together, because if we look at this data, only customer data is coming. However, the feedback or the support ticket that they have submitted is coming in this particular node. So I'm going to go back and click on this and select a merge node. In the input, that's fine. I go back and select the input 2 as well. We are going to input the same data in the input 2. Let me drag it a bit up, and then we are going to open it. We have to combine the data, and the fields to match have different names. Of course, this Google Sheet is returning us email with E capital. However, if I go to my webhook, this email is small cap. Now, if I execute this, this is going to merge my ticket message in the customer record that we have. So we have fetched the customer record and merged the ticket that they have submitted and produced a single data set out of it. Now, the next step was basically to calculate the VIP status, and if the order total is greater than 50 or rating is greater than 4.5, then it is VIP customer, otherwise not. So I'm going to click on this, and we are going to add an if node over here. And it was order history, so let's have order history is greater than, so it's a number, so we are going to have is greater than, and just for testing purpose, let's say 5. But then there was another condition which was based on the average rating, so we'll click on this, and we are going to drag this average rating as well, and this is also greater than, it's a number, so we are going to use greater than, where is it, and I'll just say 3.99. over here as well we can say 4.99. Okay, 5 or more orders, it's a VIP customer. 3.9 and above rating, it's a VIP customer. Oops, I have to change this and to or, because one of the condition needs to be true. So we're going to use the or over here. Now if I execute it, oops, something happened. So if I go back, something was wrong. Okay, merge node was not executed. So we are going to execute the merge node, and then we are going to execute the if node. Now you can see that 3 of the records have VIP status, whereas 2 of the records do not have the VIP status. So now if I go back, the next thing was, if the customer is VIP, we route it to a senior agent. Otherwise, we go into step 4 and first understand which region the customer belongs and assign the support ticket to the respective team. Now if I come over here, so the true branch is telling us it's a VIP customer. So we are going to associate a Slack node directly over here. So I'm going to click on this and send message. Click on send message. My Slack credentials are already configured. We have seen this node pretty much in action in many of the workflows that we have built. We're going to send message to a Slack channel, because there will always be a channel where multiple agents are there serving the VIP customer. So the channel could be any channel we can pick, maybe pick like high priority processing orders or maybe customer support. Okay. Simple messages. Hey, this is a VIP customer. Please check out what is going on. And if I just use expression and click on this, we can basically input the ticket message over here, right? So this is the ticket, and we can say customer name says, so John Doe says, receive damaged product, need replacement urgently. Of course, you can make this message better. You can have the contact information also sent of the customer directly to the sales agent so that they can quickly connect with them instead of, you know, doing another kind of a lookup of the customer with the name. But I believe just for demo purpose, it is fine. Let's go back. And the Slack message is active. Now, the second thing was, if the customer is not VIP, we have to first check what is the region of it. So we are going to add an if node over here again. So I'll just add an if node, and we are going to select the region. If the customer is from EU, we assign the ticket to the EU team. Otherwise, we assign it to the US team. So we have one customer of EU and the other customer is from Asia, that we will assign it to the US team because it serves our international customer. So now if we look at our workflow, final step was log ticket in support sheet. Now we are going to go back and let's add a Google Sheet node. Let's use append row in the sheet, and we are going to use the same document. Let's select sub workflows, but the sheet would be different. So sheet would be support tickets. Okay, so we are going to use this and map each column manually. So over here, it is asking for a ticket ID, customer email, issue description, team, priority status. We have everything except the ticket ID. So let's first map all of the other details which are there. So we'll map the email. We'll have the issue description, which is like the ticket message. For the team, it has to be assigned to EU team. So we are going to say EU over here. Priority, we can say as non-VIP, and status is open. Now for the ticket ID, what we can do is I can drag this ticket message over here. Okay. And if I click on dot, I can use hash. So this is going to calculate a hash of the message that is coming, and this hash most likely will be different for most of the messages coming, unless two customers share the same exact message in the same manner, same capitalization. So that's a very unique case. We are not going to solve that. We just needed a ticket ID, which is, you know, unique enough. So we are going to use this hash and I'm going to execute it. So this way we are going to log the ticket over here. So this is success. If we go to our mock data sheet, so over here, support tickets. So one ticket has been logged in with this user, the issue description, and the team is EU. Similarly, I can have another Google Sheet over here and assign it to the US team. Why I did not use the region directly over here? Because the region could be different, right? So we are just segregating EU customers to EU team, and all other customers, including Asia, Australia, are being assigned to the US team, as that is a team that is serving the entire rest of the world. But we are here to understand the concept of sub workflow. So let's leave this workflow over here. So the first workflow we have built. Now let's look at other workflows that this organization is interested in and abstract out the logic that we can reuse in other workflows as well in order to optimize them.